Okay, in this example, I'm going to go through calculating the Reynolds number, which is an important number in fluid dynamics. So the following equation can be used to calculate the Reynolds number. We have the Reynolds number is rho, which is the density, times the diameter of the pipe, times this nu, which is the fluid velocity, divided by mu, which is the fluid viscosity. And our goal is to calculate the Reynolds number for a fluid flowing through a pipe of diameter 4.3 inches, having the following properties. It's flowing at 0.037 feet per second, has a density of 1.3 grams per milliliter, and has a viscosity of 0.57 centipoise. And then we have this conversion factor that 1 centipoise is 1 times 10 to the negative 3 Pascal times seconds. So we have all our basic information written down here. And I'm just going to kind of write down my basic approach. I'm going to choose to convert to SI units just because I'm used to working in SI units. So I'm going to take my diameter in inches and convert that of ultimately to meters. I'm going to take my grams per milliliter and convert that to kilograms per meter cubed. I'm going to take my centipoise, convert that to Pascal seconds. And then ultimately, we're going to convert that to Newton per Pascal is a Newton per meter squared times seconds. And then we're going to further transform that Newton to kilogram meter per second squared. I'm going to take the velocity and convert that to meters per second. So that's sort of the basic outline of what we're going to be doing. So I'm going to start by just plugging in these variables in their original units into the equation for the Reynolds number. Now, ultimately, Reynolds number is unitless, so it doesn't have any units. The numerator and denominator units should cancel. It doesn't really matter what order you do this in. I'm going to work with getting rid of the centipoise first. So a centipoise is 0.001 Pascal times seconds. So when I do that, I can cross out the centipoise in the numerator and denominator. A Pascal is a Newton per square meter, so I can put the square meter on the top and our Pascals cancel. A Newton is a kilogram meter per second squared, so I put the second squared on top. We can cross out our Newtons on the top and bottom. Next, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the grams. So we can multiply or we can divide by 1,000 grams per kilogram and we get rid of the grams. I can then cross out the kilograms here in the numerator and denominator. I know that a milliliter is a cubic centimeter, so I'm going to write that there. Then we can cancel out the milliliters way over here on the left with here. Going to continue writing down below here. I know that there are 100 centimeters per meter, and I have to cube that because I want to get rid of the centimeter cubed here in the denominator, so I need to multiply by 100 centimeters and cube that entire thing. So that'll leave me with cubic meters. Let's now get rid of the inches here. So I know that there are 12 inches in a foot, and I know that there are 3.28 feet in a meter. So the meters, the feet cancel. The inches here cancel with the 4.3 for our denominator. And now I'm going to finally do feet per second. So I know that there is 1 meter per 3.28 feet, just as I did before. I should have a 1 here. So that'll cancel out the feet. And now if we take a look at this, let's just make sure everything's in SI units. And what we end up with is when we do the units, we end up with in the numerator, so we're just looking at what's still left. We have meters squared here. We also have a meters here and a meters here, so that's meter to the fourth. And on the denominator, we have a meters here, and we have meter cubed, so that's meter to the fourth. So you see that those cancel. So our Reynolds number is going to be unitless. Now all we need to do is just take all the values and do the multiplication and division. And what we end up with is a Reynolds number of approximately 2800. Remember, we just want to leave that to two significant figures because We don't have any, well, basically all of our inputs here into the Reynolds number have two significant figures, so we don't want to artificially create more precision than we are given. So that's our answer. The Reynolds number would be 2800.